Hi. In this video, we'll focus on more complex material rendering. Specifically, we'll focus on translucency, a material aspect that defines the amount of light that is able to travel through a surface. We'll start by discussing what Adobe Standard Material is and highlight key parameters of the translucency behavior. Then we'll delve into building a minidisc model in Modeler and refine it further with additional details in Painter. Finally, we'll take it back to Stager, tweak multiple individual properties to achieve a soft, translucent plastic look, but also darker elements that are less translucent and tweak a simple scene for a beautiful render. Adobe Standard Material, ASM in short, is a material model used in Adobe's 3D apps for physically based rendering. It ensures that materials created in any Adobe application, such as Substance 3D Designer, Painter, Sampler, or Stager, look the same. It also helps you achieve similar visuals in other apps using PBR rendering. In this video, we'll focus on the translucency parameters, which are essential for translucent materials such as plastic, certain glass, and liquids. In our case, we will create a translucent minidisc material with it. Translucent materials let some light pass through while retaining reflections. Depending on the roughness, they make objects behind it fully visible or blurry. Several parameters control the translucency, color and absorption. Let's check out some of these settings. Translucency is used to control the amount of light that is transmitted through the surface. Absorption color is the color that light becomes when it is absorbed. Absorption distance is the distance light travels before absorption color is reached. A value of 0 means that thickness has no effect on absorption color. Let's start to model a minidisc in Substance Modeler by defining the base shapes. Increasing the resolution is needed for smaller details and a smooth look. Boolean operations are a fast way to cut out or connect shapes together, and with the Erase tool we simply can delete certain parts. While modeling, we always have to check the model from different angles. To see the part we're working on perfect, we can hide the other parts. For symmetrical parts, we use the symmetry settings, which speeds up the workflow by mirroring in multiple axes. Another awesome tool is the Warp tool. It's perfect to deform shapes, and with the falloff, we have great control over it. When we use base shapes, we have great control over it by using taper, fillet, chamfer, and thickness. This really helps to get the base for more complex shapes really fast. By using stamps, we define the model really fast with additional details. Let's choose FBX as file format, then we tweak the triangles count to a high enough number to retain the crisp details. We can either unwrap it in Modeler or do it later in Painter. These simple steps give you a basic minidisc model. For finer details, we can always use Substance Painter. Painter lets us add tertiary details in the texture instead of geometry. It's great because it allows us to keep a reasonable resolution in Modeler while being non-destructive at the same time. Let's check out how to do that. While importing it into Painter, we select the ASM Metallic Roughness shader. Be aware that auto-unwrapping can take a while. Let's add finer details to the back part. Using masks is a fast way to emboss additional details, such as logos or indents, to the model. In some cases, we only want to add detail to the normals and height, while in others, we may specifically want to add a logo to the base color. Using pre-built materials really helps to speed up the workflow too. We can use Painter just for additional normal information, leaving the other maps untouched for now. Let's finally send it over to Substance 3D Stager by using Send Tool. Back in Stager, our model appears right away in the center of the scene. Using Send Tool and ASM materials make it very easy to jump between applications. First, we scale the object 10 times bigger. Let's start with the front piece. For a smooth look, we reduce the roughness to a really low value. In the interior, we increase the translucency to 1 and choose a nice light bluish color. For the back part, we choose a higher roughness value because it has more structure. To support this, we don't make it fully translucent. Because it isn't fully translucent, we have to adjust the absorption and base color. Let's further tweak the inner parts. We again raise up the translucency and this time choose a darker blue. Then we increase the absorption distance. This really helps to make it look a bit less translucent and support the impression of a bit thicker parts. If we want to obtain damage information on the front part, we can enhance the coat's opacity slightly and add a scratches texture into the coat's normals. For the simple metal parts, we use a simple brushed metal material with slightly pushed roughness. To achieve high quality product rendering, accurate material setup, good models, and proper lighting are essential. The lighting especially helps to make the product look believable. Experiment with different light setups such as physical lights, studio or outdoor environment lights, or a combination of those, to find the one that works best for your scene. In this case, I use the sunset environment light to achieve a warm lighting and a light blue background color. I added planes to block distracting light and focus more onto the minidisc. To get even more interesting central shadows, I used the window model from the asset library. As ground, I simply activated the ground play in the environment tab. By increasing the shadow and reflection opacity sliders, I obtained nice shadows and strong reflections. Additionally, I slightly increased the reflection roughness to soften the reflections slightly. I hope we've clarified how to use translucency in Substance 3D Stager. Good luck using it in your own projects!